Schon spätestens seit der Avantgarde des letzten Jahrhunderts haben sich ja auch die Künstler intensiv mit der Frage beschäftigt, was eigentlich das Museum ausmacht, ja, welche Rolle spielt das Museum im Zusammenhang mit der Vermittlung, also nicht nur der Präsentation, sondern auch der Vermittlung, der Erforschung von Kunst. Dann gab es aber natürlich auch eine ganze Reihe von Künstlern, die dann selbst Museen gegründet haben, vornehmlich um ihre eigene Arbeit zu zeigen, teilweise aber auch um die Arbeit von Künstlerkollegen zu zeigen.
The whole museum, the whole Cinati Foundation, plus even I personally feel the whole Judd Foundation, this is not a museum, this is just one big piece of art. He wanted to found a museum and he had the standard of the Paris Iridium meter, the Urmeter, okay? There's one piece in the world that defines physically the length of 1 meter. This is in Paris in a vitrine, and he wanted that for contemporary art in Marfa, Texas. So, you know, all of you here and outside, this is the one museum on the planet, and the rest, please, okay, debatable. And he was certainly looking for ideal spaces, spaces that give him the feeling that everything is right. Like one could say, like your home, but you know, the home is the wrong. It is the wrong association. Everything is right. Everything is well arranged for you, but also for visitors. I think you know this cycle of the day that you're awake, that you're interested, that you watch, but that you also want to rest and contemplate. That he wanted to have together. For us, art has so many purposes. For him, it was this. It's kind of a cycle.
You can think of museums as hardware or as software. You know, like a museum can be something that is like a physical, that occupies space, or it can be a structure to file content. It needs no budget, no staff, no, you know, like you just unpack it and install it. The museum that you can do. Even if you have any money, even you know, like even if you are outside the legitimization space of the art institution, this is an activity that still can be meaningful for the few persons that engage in the activity. The places where you, the museum as a place where you find inspiration from the muses, in a way, you know, like a, it's like a. It's a space that is not a space for work, it's not a space for education, it's a space for reveries and wandering, you know?
To what extent does such a living structure changes when the author, the artist, is dead? Is there a process of musealization?
Judd left something and he didn't die intentionally. I mean, he had a cancer that took him away like within like 6 weeks. He thought he has a flu and he had cancer and bong, this was it. It is a miracle that it survived. I mean, this guy really said the Taj Mahal of America because he meant it.
That's why Pedro said, talked about pilgrimage.
Yes,
I think this
pilgrimage, you're right,
yeah.
And sacred place. So to answer your question, what are you doing with such a place? We do not want to make it sacred. It is maybe sacred. I love it. And other people who come there, they're all blown away. It's extremely beautiful. Everybody says this is a life-changing experience. My personal responsibility is that I have to do some preservation. A lot of the buildings are falling apart. So this is my job. And we have big education to do. We have school children in Marfa and in the counties around there. We want to do exhibitions. We want to attract artists in residence because this is a living example for young artists. So we want to do everything that a museum does, but we will not really change. When I grew up, it was still impossible to study 20th century art at universities. And you have these museums who administrate the whole stuff, and they have extremely, not today, at that time, and they have extremely little knowledge. And this is what artists found out, of course, very early. I mean, I mentioned the name Clifford Still. He hated museum directors. He hated curators because he said they know absolutely nothing about my work.
In the 90s, there was many artists like opening spaces, and there's more now, like as the museums now, there's like a wide range of museums that have like a very, okay, very good programs. Now there's more like the need to do critical space. So there's more spaces, you know, like a more spaces that are being opened by artists in order to debate or publish or teach.